Hi, and welcome to this Tech Insights video. My name is Mary, and I'm an application engineer here at IFM Effector. You are here because you have either purchased or plan to purchase one of our LMT sanitary point level sensors. In this video, we are going to go over the installation guidelines of these sensors, so let's get started. So here you have the Learn More section on our website for our LMT series level sensors. In this video, we are going over the installation guidelines of these sensors, which can be found under the Setup and Support tab here. In this section, we go over the adapters we recommend for these sensors, the installation locations that are recommended, as well as the O-rings for the appropriate LMT sensors. So first, let's look at the adapters and the fittings for these sensors. We always recommend using IFM adapters because this will guarantee the peak to metal seal that is required for the sanitary approval. Here we have an image of what it looks like to make the seal between the metal sealing cone of the adapter and the peak tip of the sensor. Next, we have images that go over the recommended mounting locations. We do not recommend mounting these sensors in the locations marked 1, and this is to avoid any buildup that may cause false readings on the sensor that cannot drain out in the application. And finally, we go over the O-rings recommended for the different LMT sensors. For the shorter probed LMTs, such as the LMT-100, the LMT-110, and the LMT-121, these sensors do not come with O-rings because the seal is made between the peak and the metal of the adapter, which I showed you above. The adapters do, however, come with an O-ring that is meant for the sealing between the top of the adapter and the sensor housing, as you can see here marked 1. And this is to help avoid any contaminants from outside of the application getting into the threading of the adapter. Next, we also show you the O-rings recommended for the longer probed LMTs, such as the LMT-104 and the LMT-105. These sensors come with a green flat seal, which can be used in non-sanitary applications. However, in sanitary applications, you would need the E43323 accessory. And here we have an image that shows you how to replace that flat seal with the sanitary O-ring. Finally, the last thing to note is that with the longer LMT probes, such as the LMT-104 and the LMT-105, there is a captive O-ring between the peak material and the stainless steel material at the tip of the probe. Because of this O-ring not being replaceable or serviceable, that makes these longer probed LMTs not have the requirements to meet the 3A approvals. Now let me show you how to navigate to the datasheet of your specific part number to find the technical details of that sensor. If you scroll to the top where we have the search term bar, you can enter the part number of your specific sensor. In this example, I'm using an LMT-121, and you can press enter. Then you will see it'll bring you to the datasheet of that sensor where you have the specific technical details for that part number, the accessories tab, and the downloads tab where you can find your operating instructions. Now, if you want to get back to that Learn More page, you can scroll to the top where you will see residue suppression level switches for sanitary applications type LM. If you click on this, it'll take you back to the overview page of the LMT sensors, and here you will find the orange Learn More button. If you click here, it'll bring you back to the Learn More section of the LMT sensors. So that concludes this Tech Insights video on the installation guidelines of our LMT sanitary point level sensors. As always, you can check out the Learn More section on our website for helpful information on any of our products. Feel free to contact us at info.us@ifm.com or call into 1-800-441-8246 to speak with somebody who can assist you. Thank you for your time and have a great day.